Dealing drugs on campus. Seven middle schoolers now facing charges. Good evening. I'm Jim Payne.
And I'm Martha Sagowski. Two arrested for selling drugs at Sanford Middle School. Five others busted for possession. West Shore reporter Dave McDaniel joins us live with the late-breaking details. And Dave, these kids are young.
Well, they are young. You know, you hear drugs on a campus, a middle school campus at that. All of that is certainly unsettling. But then police tell you that a 13-year-old was known by the kids here as the campus drug dealer.
Oh, there shouldn't be any children with drugs and anything going on here.
The parent of a seventh grader surprised to hear about on-campus middle school drug arrests. Seven students busted at Sanford Middle, five with marijuana, one with prescription pills crushed into powder, and one child, only 13, in deep trouble, accused of selling pot, cocaine, as well as crushed up prescription pills packaged for sale.
I've got middle school kids, and I wouldn't think that there'd be cocaine in middle school, but yes, there is.
The case started with a student coming forward as a whistleblower, even though that student is himself in trouble for having prescription powder with him. He says he got it from the middle school age drug dealer.
I don't think they were large quantities, Dave, but they're enough to disrupt the school, disrupt the learning process for everybody involved.
We do not tolerate drugs on campus.
Sanford Middle is an A-rated school. Kids from outside the geographic zone can choose to come here. A school with such a great reputation, then this.
This is one of those societal issues that walks in the front door, and we have to deal with if this presence is going to be on our campus, we're not going to tolerate it, and we're going to clean the school out as best we can.
I always tell her to stay away from that, yes.
Police and school officials are telling all parents, children are never too young to start talking about avoiding drugs. Because all of the students are so young, we are not naming any of them. I can tell you, though, they all face the possibility of either being suspended or expelled from school. Letters went home with parents today so they know exactly what's going on. And I can also tell you that six of the seven kids were processed and they went home to their parents. But the 13-year-old who told police that the $50 in his pocket was from drug sales on campus yesterday morning, he's sitting in juvenile hall. Reporting live in Sanford, Seminole County, Dave McDaniel, West 2 News.